Hi, I'm Corey Barger, and this is Bassoon Lessons Online, where I help you learn to play the bassoon with more confidence and ease. Hit subscribe so that you don't miss any lessons, and share with your friends so that they don't miss any lessons either. Today's topic is intonation. There are a lot of intonation problems on the bassoon sometimes, and most of the time I like to frame this as more of a long-term project than something that can be solved right away, but there are certain things that we can do that will immediately shift the intonation of a note. Most other instruments can make adjustments by pulling out a joint or pushing in a joint or something like that, but unfortunately that does not apply to the bassoon. So if any of you have had a director or a conductor ask you to do something like that, what I would recommend that you do is that you pretend to make a little bit of an adjustment on the vocal, but don't actually do anything, because first of all, it doesn't really help the intonation, and second of all, it may make some unevenness in the scale of your bassoon that would be kind of counterproductive. So the bassoon is not an instrument that you can just pull out or push in. There are 7 strategies that I use to change intonation, 2 of which are external to yourself. So the first one would be to get different reeds. You can try a different shape, a different length of reed. You can alter your reeds if you're comfortable doing that to help deal with intonation. But a lot of times making an external change isn't as consistent as we would want it to be, which then leads me to the second way to change intonation on the bassoon, which is by getting a different vocal or crook. You may have seen that there are numbers on your vocal, 1, 2, 3, maybe even 0. This is telling you the length of the vocal, and you can get a different one that would be a different length. So most of the time, people will play on a 2. If you want to play higher, you'll get a 1 or a 0, and if you want to play lower, you'll get a 3. So a 3 is longer than a 2 is. A 2 is longer than a 1 is longer than a 0. In my experience, making this kind of change actually doesn't make that much of a difference. I've had countless students that play very sharp, and I've switched them to a number 3 vocal, and they continue to play at exactly the same pitch level, even though the vocal is technically supposed to drop their pitch by up to 20 cents. So really, what I believe about intonation is that it comes from our ears, and if you are not consistent in projecting and imagining the sound that you want, you're going to kind of get whatever intonation the bassoon wants to give you. So it's very important to consider ear training and to establish some consistent patterns in practicing intonation. So let's get to the 5 ways that you can change your intonation internally and consistently. The first one is your embouchure. We'll start from basically outside in. Making any changes in your embouchure can be very, very effective in changing the pitch. It will be immediate, and it will probably be fairly extreme. So if we start out on a note and we want it to be higher, you can tighten up your embouchure, and the note will go pretty high. There are a lot of downsides to this. First being, it can make you really tired if you're consistently trying to, what we say, lip up any note. Second, it's really hard to control. It's very hard for us to tell exactly how much any adjustment is going to be. Like for example, if I tell you to tighten your lips 20%, you're gonna be like, I don't understand what that means. I don't know how much that is. It's hard to reproduce these sorts of results. So while it is effective, I don't rely on that for my main intonation adjustments, but it's pretty simple. So say we wanna make the note higher. We tighten up. Makes a really big difference. But listen also to what happens. The sound becomes really not very pleasant. It gets very closed up, because that's actually exactly what we're doing to the reed. When you squeeze your embouchure, you squeeze the reed, and the amount of air that you're able to get through diminishes. It's going to affect the sound, it's going to muffle the vibrations. So I would really only use this in an emergency if you've tried the following strategies and they're not enough. One adjustment that often is very helpful in embouchure is opening up your embouchure. And I tell a lot of students to do this because generally people are very tense and tight, especially as beginners when they're playing the bassoon. It's important that we relax the embouchure more, open the lips so that they're just a little softer than you want them to be. You may feel that this is inconsistent. You might feel some wobbling. It's going to feel uncomfortable if you're used to having a fairly tight embouchure, but it'll give you a more open sound and it will help drop the pitch. So most of the time when students play sharp, it's because they're really grabbing tight with their lips. So opening your lips, softening your embouchure, is going to lower the pitch. So the second strategy that's internal, so this is actually, let's see, one, two, three, this is the fourth intonation strategy, is to change the position of your jaw. This is another fairly dramatic change that's also a little bit difficult to quantify. So I would again use it only in an emergency, but the same concept applies. If you want to raise the pitch, you tighten your jaw up, and if you want to lower the pitch, you drop it. You're limited by physical things, how much you can do this. Obviously, you can't open your mouth so much that the reed is no longer enclosed by your lips, and you can't close your mouth so much that your teeth are closed, because then the reed won't be able to vibrate at all. But it will make a big difference. Some people may even actually shift their head up and down. I would really recommend against doing that, just because it gives you a very unstable place for the reed. We want to create as consistent of an embouchure and jaw experience as we can, just for a uniformity of sound. That leads me to my favorite way of adjusting pitch, which is changing the position of your tongue inside your mouth. I use the concept of voicing and vowels to make this a very quantifiable concept. So say, for example, you are playing a little bit high and you want to lower the pitch of the note, you need to have your tongue drop down a little bit. Again, we can think, okay, lower your tongue, but that's kind of an abstract thing. Whereas if we think of using a different vowel, that will lower our tongue, and we already know how to do that because we spend all day long speaking. So consider what vowel you are already using when you play the note. So I'm going to play C right now. And that feels like an to me. You may be using a different one. So think of what other vowels would make a lower tongue position. Has kind of a U-shaped tongue for me. It hits my teeth on the inside, but it creates like a little bit of a channel for the air to go straight through. If I think of something like aw, my tongue is going to drop down at the front of my mouth, but raise up a little bit at the back. Let's see what that does. Aw, versus aw. That was and this is aw. Pretty dramatic difference. If you find the right vowel for your note, it's going to be a lot easier for you to be consistent with playing it in tune. Eventually, you may go through your scale and find that each note has its own ideal vowel. And I have done that in the past. Sometimes you need to change things a lot, so it's important to be flexible, but it's a good idea to quantify these kinds of things. It's very helpful. The next strategy is to use your throat to help change the pitch. If you think of opening your throat up more, you're going to have a lower pitch. If you think of raising it a little bit, then you will have a higher pitch. I think of this as like singing a low note versus singing a high note. That sort of adjustment in your throat will cause a different sort of airstream to come out of you. So here is me trying to lower the note. Causes a little bit of wobble because the muscles here are becoming, they're going to a place that is not comfortable or consistent for me. But with practice, you can stabilize a wobble like that, no problem. Let's go a little bit higher by raising up your throat muscles. That can often, again, create a more constricted sort of sound. So be careful with this adjustment. Anytime you're making any intonation adjustments, you must consider the tone quality. Don't change the tone quality so drastically that you really lose the note's sparkle. Some notes have intonation issues that are very severe. Like, for example, D above the staff. Often students play that note so that it's so low and it's very difficult to get it high enough. So sometimes you do have to distort the tone quality to get it up. But with practice, you will be able to maintain the nice quality of sound that you had before. So really just keep that in mind. I want to warn you against distorting anything with especially higher pitch adjustments. So the last way to change your pitch on the bassoon is a little more abstract, but sometimes I find it very helpful. I think of a lot of metaphors to do this kind of thing, and if all of my tricks just aren't doing enough, sometimes thinking of, if I'm trying to drop the pitch, thinking about my feet will allow me to relax down, thinking about just like relaxing my entire body in relation to the instrument, getting more openness in my torso, in my pelvis. Those kinds of adjustments will allow the pitch to drop. So let's see what happens as I think down. It does change. This sort of adjustment, I really think, is more suited to dropping things down, because if you're thinking about raising things up, you're going to end up with a lot of tension, so be careful about that, but it will make a fairly dramatic adjustment. So now I'm going to think about higher things like the top of my head, or top of a tree, or the clouds, or, you know, an airplane, or whatever, like whatever gets you to that space. So, you have a lot of strategies to help your intonation. I want to give you one final requirement for all of these tools, and that's that you must be supporting enough in order for any of them to be reliable or working at all. If your support is not consistent, if it is not sufficient for any of the notes to be at a stable level, then you're going to get a whole lot of variable pitch. It's going to be really difficult to hold anything stable, and it's going to be pretty much impossible to maintain that. So if you're having trouble with your support, or if you don't know what I mean, make sure you check out the video that is teaching you how to use your support better and how to make sure that your breath is really strong and supported. Thanks so much for watching Bassoon Lessons Online. Please hit subscribe and share with all of your friends.